achieve a sort of symbiosis with artificial intelligence. You can effectively have the option of merging with AI. And this is extremely important. And we hope to have this aspirationally in a human patient before the end of next year. So this is not far.
You scare the shit out of me when you talk about AI.
So as you have seen, what Elon Musk is saying is connecting the human brain with artificial intelligence to symbiotically work together. But why is that?
You scare the shit out of me when you talk about AI. Are you honestly legitimately concerned about this?
It's not necessarily bad. It's just, it's definitely going to be outside of human control.
One of the things you spend an awful lot of time thinking about, I know, is artificial intelligence. A lot of experts in AI don't share the same level of concern that you do.
The biggest issue I see with so-called AI experts is that they think they know more than they do. And they think they're smarter than they actually are. In general, we are all much smarter than we think we are, but much less smart, dumber than we think we are, by a lot. So this tends to plague smart people. They just can't. They define themselves by their intelligence, and they don't like the idea that a machine could be way smarter than them. So they discount the idea, which is fundamentally flawed. That's the wishful thinking situation. I'm really quite close to, I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows. So the rate of improvement is really dramatic. We have to figure out some way to ensure that the advent of digital superintelligence is one which is symbiotic with humanity. Mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes. And Neuralink is trying to help in that regard by creating an interface between, a high bandwidth interface between AI and human brain.
Okay, so well, now you understand why Elon Musk wants to connect artificial intelligence with human intelligence. So he's worried that artificial intelligence alone is growing too fast. So how Elon Musk and Neuralink are planning to connect human intelligence with artificial intelligence? Stay tuned, we'll see it right now.
Our goal is to record from and stimulate spikes in neurons and do so in a way that is orders of magnitude more than anything that's been done to date, and safe and good enough that you can, it's not like a major operation. It's sort of equivalent to sort of a LASIK type of thing. The system, even in version one that we're going to unveil today, is capable of 1,000 times more electrodes than the best system out there. And they're all read and write. So this is really quite, I think, I mean, for something to be 1,000 times more than what is publicly approved is quite a big difference.
We knew, as Elon mentioned, that whatever we built, we wanted it to be completely wireless. It had to be something that would last for a long period of time, not something that you'd have to take out at 2, 3, or 4 years in. And the central component of that is the N1 sensor. It's a little hermetic package. It's when it's fully assembled, this is missing an outer mold. It's into an 8 millimeter diameter, 4 millimeter tall cylinder. Exploding it, opening it up a little bit, you can see there's the thin film, which has the threads that Elon talked about, which is the wisp going off to the side. There's a hermetic substrate, and then that gets welded later to a package that goes over top, and that's mated to our custom electronic. We can place, as Elon mentioned, many of these, possibly up to 10. In one hemisphere, for our first patients, we're looking at four sensors. Three in motor areas and one in a somatosensory area. And that connects wirelessly through the skin to a wearable device that we call the Link.
What Neuralink wants to do is to give people the ability to tap into those representations, to get better access to that information, both to repair broken brain circuits and also to ultimately give us better access to better connections to the world, to each other.
So this was a very interesting video, and you have seen how Neuralink, the company funded / supported by Elon Musk is planning to connect artificial intelligence with human intelligence. And it wants to be the response to this problem of AI going out of control. But actually, the problem of AI going out of control is more of a problem of another entity, artificial intelligence, evolving more rapidly than human beings. Now, if you're interested in this topic and you want to learn more about whether or not it's possible that human beings can counter artificial intelligence, we have another video coming soon. So stay tuned on Conversation Artificial Intelligence or on Innodemia, and we'll come back with more on this very topic.